गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग चैप्टर नंबर 2 माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स फ्रेम एंड कोइल। सो हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द वर्ड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म। माइक्रो दैट मींस वेरी स्मॉल ऑर्गेनिज्म व्हिच आर कैन नॉट सी बाय आवर अनएडेड आई, व्हिच इज वेरी स्मॉल। We have seen with the help of the microscope that type of organism. We have seen with the help of microorganism. So this kind of organism are known as microorganism. So in this chapter, we will study about microorganism which are harmful to us and as well as they are friendly to us. Right? So here we will study about different types of microorganism. Right? So what type of that microorganism gives us some types of example of that microorganism? So here bacteria, fungi, protozoa and viruses, they are a microorganism which we cannot see with our unaided eye. We will use a microscope for observing them, different types of function they will do. We will study one by one in this chapter. So here you can see a different types of microorganisms. Here there is protozoa, this is a paramecium, chlamydomonas. These are the microorganisms which we will see with the help of microorganism. So here is a virus. What is virus? Virus is the same kind of microorganism which we can use, which we can see with the help of microorganism. As you all aware about the coronavirus, that in today's world, coronavirus harmful, how many death causes with the help of that coronavirus. Have anybody seen coronavirus in the air? No. Why? They are not visible to us in our unaided eye. So what we will do, some symptoms we observe like a fever, common cold and cough, right? So we just go to the laboratory center and we just take a report and we have found that we are positive, then the virus in our body, then we realize that virus in our body we cannot see by with the help of unaided eye. So here, so that particular organisms are known as microorganisms, right? So here is some pictures I draw. Amoeba, paramecium, they are unicellular, they have only single cell, that they are known as unicellular organism, which can perform all the activities like digestion, absorption, each excretion, all the activities done by only single cell. So that is known as unicellular organism. These organisms are very small, right? So now here you can see different types of picture like amoeba. This is a bacteria. There are two pictures, different types of that are bacteria. Here is amoeba, paramecium, chlamydomonas, algae, right? These are the different features you have seen on that screen. So now the question arises that, so where do microorganisms live? So you can say that in some cold climate or in hot spring climate and desert to marshy land, they can survive. We can see with the help of magnifying glass, we can see the bread, and we can put a bread 2 to 3 days. So we observe that fungi is really like black patches on the bread. We can see with the help of that magnifying glass, right? So here we can say that where do microorganisms live? Microorganisms live in a very cold climate as well as in a hot and marshy desert plain, that microorganism live, right? So here, microorganism, what is the relationship between microorganism and us? Why we study this chapter microorganism? So here we can detailed analysis, detailed discussion with the microorganism. They are helpful to us. Microorganism, they are friendly to us. How? In various purpose, microorganism are helpful to us, like making the curd and bread. You know that your mother is making the curd at your home with the help of you just take a milk and put a 2 to 3 spoon of curd in that milk. So after some time, after 12 to 14 hours, we have seen that the total milk, whatever we take, 1 liter or 2 liter, total milk is now converting into curd. Why? So some bacteria are present in that curd, okay, that can spoil, that can make a curd to whole milk, that is curd. For bread, we can use a different types of microorganism. With the help of that microorganism, we can making a bread. You have seen that idli, rava, that type of food we eat, they are prepared by the some microorganism, right? So we can say that microorganism are friendly to us in different aspect. Now here commercial use of microorganism. So in commercial use, we use with the help of wine, alcohol, this type of material, where product will produce with the help of yeast, that is converted into sugar, right? So we can say that with the help of yeast, we can microorganism, commercial use of microorganism with the help of microorganism, we can prepare alcohol, right? Now medicinal use of microorganism. Suppose we are facing some fever or cold cough, like a bacterial infection. As we go that at a clinic or hospital, so doctor said that this is a viral infection. You just take these medicines like azithromycin, streptomycin. These are the medicine which will made by some microorganism. So that microorganism, we take just that medicine, and that viral infection, that disease, that organism are killed, that are known as antibiotic. That particular medicine is known as antibiotic, and just we take an antibiotic in our body, that all organism they can kill with the help of this antibiotic medicine. Now increasing soil fertility. So we have seen that we have used different types of, in chapter number we have studied that compost and manure, right? So some microorganism which we can use to increase in the soil fertility. In chapter number 1 we have used that urea, and that are different types of fertilizers which we can use to increase the soil fertility. So here are some microorganism that we can use to increase the soil fertility. Now cleaning the environment. Some microorganisms are also used in the cleaning the atmosphere, cleaning the environment. So these different types of method, these are the different factors which the microorganisms which are friendly to us. So we can say that here the different types of microorganism, where they live, their places, how they form, how the different types of microorganism, algae, protozoa, fungi, right, yeast, viruses, that can not seen by our unaided eye. So that particular thing is known as microorganism. So here today in this lecture, we have seen that different types of microorganism, and their places where they live, and they are how to friendly to us in different purposes, how they help to us in our making in our food, commercial use, to produce wine and alcohol, right? We have medicinal use of different types of antibiotic which can build our antibodies. Vaccine is build our antibodies. As you know that in coronavirus we just take a vaccine, right? Whatever the Covaxin or Covishield or Johnson & Johnson, different types of vaccine is available in market. So they can build our antibodies. So for that, if our antibodies are increasing, so that particular disease cannot harmful to us. Like your well example is corona. If you take a vaccine, that corona is not affect much more. So here the different types of uses: microorganism, baking cord, bread, commercial use, increasing soil fertility for production, crop production, fertility production, soil fertility is also microorganism also useful. Cleaning the environment, here the some microorganisms which can clean the environment, right? So here today we will learn about the different types of microorganisms, okay, and how they helpful to us. In the next lecture we will see that how harmful they are, how they can spread their disease in our, like virus, cholera, typhoid, malaria, this type of disease is spread by this bacteria. So how we can prevent from these different types of disease, and what are the preventive measures, how they form that type of disease, and how can we prevent. So then all the things, how they are harmful to us, these microorganisms, bacteria, we will learn in our next video lecture. So till then, thank you, bye bye. We'll be right back.